Hello everyone, and welcome to the Nucular Electronics channel. This is a guide on how to install the kit in the Apollo RFN. The kit is compatible with both the off-road and street-legal versions of the Apollo. Open the battery lid if you haven't already, unplug the wires, and remove the battery. The first thing to do is remove the factory controller lid. Loosen the screws, securing the phase and power terminals, and unscrew them. Unscrew the four screws holding the controller in place. Unplug the hole connector. Remove the controller carefully from its place and unplug the main low current connector. Remove the decorative plastic pad and the rubber battery support. Using a thin settled screwdriver or other thin tool, unplug all the JWPF connectors in the head tube area. These are two end connectors, one display connector, and one remote control connector. The large ignition key connector should remain intact. Remove the factory display, it's secured with two screws. Take it away, you're not gonna need it anymore. Screw the fixing screws back in their places. Make sure they're securely tightened. Unplug the end connector of the footrest sensor in the motor area. Unplug the throttle connector. From this bunch of wires, we'll need two plus and minus terminals. The green and red small terminals, the communication connector that's going to the battery, and the plugged ignition key connector, which we left intact. We recommend that you gather all that's left of the wiring into a space-efficient bundle using ties, and leave the unplugged JWPF connectors around the steering column, under the rubber battery support, and the metal battery support. Plug in sensors to the wiring kit. These are three sensors, right and left brake handle and the kickstand. Plug in the remote control in the handlebar. For the street-legal version, plug in the connectors marked L1E in the middle of any brake sensor connector. Plug in the hole connector. Plug in the throttle connector. Install the mount for the new display on the handlebar. Put the display wire into the battery compartment. Secure the display on the handlebar mount. Now you can install the decorative plastic pad. Make sure the wires are positioned properly, without creases and bundles. You can also install the rubber battery support. Make sure all the wires are underneath it. Put something soft on the bottom for protection. Remove all wires except for phase wires. Put the controller in the soft material and, without securing the controller, screw in phase wires. After that, bend the wires the way that they're not gonna cause too much strain when bending. Next, you can cover the phase wires that are in the kit with the lid. Put the thermal pad underneath the controller and don't forget to remove the protective material covering both sides of the thermal pad. Remove the soft material that we put at the bottom for avoiding scratches. Put the bottom plastic controller mounting piece and use it to secure the controller at the bottom without tightening the screws completely. This is somewhat uncomfortable, but phase wires are rigid and can get in the way. Install the top plastic controller mounting piece. Once all four mounting screws are in place, you can tighten them. Plug all the low current connectors into the controller according to the instructions. Be careful not to confuse the plugs. When the controller is installed, it's difficult to unplug them. Screw the power line coming from the battery to the plus and minus ends of the controller. Along with them, you need to attach two red and green terminals from the factory wiring. Bend the power line as shown in the video, then secure it with the plastic power line bracket. Once you've secured the power line, organize the rest of the wiring. Tie down everything that is sticking out. Make sure the polarity is not reversed. Reinstall the battery. Plug in the battery's power and low current connectors. Make sure the battery is not pressing on the wires. Start the bike by turning the key. The onboard computer screen should light up within a few seconds. Now the bike is ready to go. Install the plastic pressure plate and the saddle. Let's get to the first controller setup. Before starting the auto setup, be sure to secure the bike so that the rear wheel is hanging in the air. It'll be rotating during the setup, so be careful. Go to the settings, select the device, then the controller, and then auto setup, and then full setup. The Apollo doesn't have the analog brake, so the brake setup will show that the brake is not connected. When setting up the throttle, first press the throttle fully, following the on-screen instructions, then release the throttle. After that, the motor setup will start. Wait until it's complete. Auto setup implies that you have already downloaded the controller settings for Apollo. If not, you can download the settings file from the website by clicking the link in the video description. Save this file to your SD card and import it. You can then run the full auto setup. Once the angle correction is complete, you can put the wheel on the ground. The controller will determine the motor resistance and inductance. The motor setup is now complete. Go back to the initial section of the settings, go to the onboard computer menu, main screen setup, battery capacity, and, depending on the parameters of your battery, specify the battery capacity. If you have an upgraded battery, you'll also need to enter your battery settings in the controller menu, battery. Don't forget to save the settings. Done! Return to the main screen and raise the kickstand. Now you can test the shifter on the left side and the throttle. If you still have any questions, you can ask them in our Telegram group or on our website. All the links are in the video description. Have a nice ride, and I'll see you soon.